बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ़ यू आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल। लेट्स स्टार्ट अगेन विद एन अदर चैप्टर फ्रॉम द हिस्ट्री पोर्शन, दैट इज़ फ्रॉम द बुक द हिस्ट्री एंड कल्चर ऑफ पाकिस्तान, एंड द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज़ 2059 एंड दिस इज़ फॉर ग्रेड 01। ओके, द चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इज चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट इज रिलेटेड टू हाउ इम्पॉर्टेंट वॉज द वर्क ऑफ सर सैयद अहमद खान टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान। सो द कॉन्टेंट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इज, फर्स्ट इज सर सैयद्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू द एजुकेशन ऑफ मुस्लिम्स एंड द रिवाइटलाइजेशन ऑफ देयर नेशनल कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज। सेकेंड इज हिज सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल थेरी एंड इट्स ओरिजिन। Then impact of his work on Muslims and the Western world, then his relations with the British and the ulama, and the reasons for the foundation of Aligarh College, and his roles in Indian National Congress. So today we will shed light on these topics. Okay, first one is Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan, and the rank is from 1817 till 1898, and today और वी विल फर्स्ट डिस्कस द अर्ली बायोग्राफिकल डिटेल्स। फर्स्ट ही वॉज बॉर्न इन 1817 इन दिल्ली, देन बिलोंग्स टू वेल्दी फैमिली, रिसीव्ड हाई क्वालिटी एजुकेशन, स्किल्ड इन अरबिक, पर्शियन, मैथमेटिक्स एंड मेडिसन बाय द एज ऑफ 18, एंड ही फोर्स्ड टू सीक एम्प्लॉयमेंट व्हेन हिज फादर डाइड इन 1838। इन 1846 ही बिकेम जज इन दिल्ली। He wrote a famous book on archaeology called Athar al-Sanadid in 1846. So these were the major points that you have to remember while reading the early biographical details. Okay, during the War of Independence in 1857, he was working as judge and saved many children and women from fighting. British offered him a large state with good income as reward of his loyalty, but he refused. He believed that uprisings against the British at that time were fruitless. This belief declined his popularity, but he kept on working for reconciliation between British and Muslims. He was appointed as Chief Justice in Moradabad. Later he was transferred to Ghazipur. In 1864, he was transferred to Aligarh, where he played an important part in establishing a new college. Okay, in 1876, he retired from his job and devoted his life for education and running of college. He also worked on improving position of Muslims in the subcontinent through education. Aligarh became the center of a Muslim renaissance. He died on 27th March 1898, having served his fellow Muslims in a way which few had revolved. So, this was all about the early life of Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. Now, we will talk about the beliefs of Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan. So, first, Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan was extremely unhappy about the position of Muslims in subcontinent. As we have studied in the previous chapter, that after the War of Independence, the Muslims were weakening and their position was weakening in the subcontinent. So, Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan was extremely unhappy about the position of Muslims in subcontinent. Their social and economic status was declining after the Mughal Empire and the War of Independence. Sir Sayyid felt the poor status of Muslims and the second-class treatment from British and Hindus. So he wanted Muslims to take the responsibility to change their position. Many Muslims considered British to be little more than invaders, but Sir Sayyid wanted Muslims to realize that Muslims were ruler who intended to stay for many years. So Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan wanted to realize this thing by the Muslims. Okay, so he believed that Muslims should show positive attitude towards British in order to improve their position in the subcontinent. Sir Sayyid also believed that in order to prosper, Muslims should get benefits from British education. Otherwise, Hindu would prosper because they were showing a positive attitude towards British education. Sir Sayyid wanted to see Muslims united and prospering. He wanted to see improvements in Muslims' economic, social, political, and religious fortune. So he laid the foundation of Aligarh movement. So he was always in a search that how the position of the Muslims in the subcontinent be increased or aims of Aligarh movement. The movement that he started and the aims were improve relations between British and Muslims communities by removing British doubts about Muslim loyalty and Muslims doubts about British intentions. Improve the social and economic position of Muslims by encouraging them to receive Western education and take positions in military. Increase the political awareness of Muslim community. He wanted to aware the Muslims to the threats to their position from Hindus' policies of cooperation with British. So, work of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, now we will shed light on this thing that because he have realized many things in the subcontinent that the position of the Muslims were weakening and in order to gain back their position, they need to learn the culture and language of the British. So first work was around improving relations between the British and Muslim communities, convincing the British. So first he did this thing that he convinced the British. In 1860, he wrote The Loyal Mohammedans of India. In this book, he defended the Muslims from British accusations that they were disloyal. Sir Syed wrote a pamphlet called Essay on the Causes of the Indian Revolt. In this, he pointed main reasons for the uprisings, and those were the lack of representation for Indians in the government of the country, the forcible conversion of Muslims to Christianity. So he talked about these things that these were the main causes of the War of Independence, and all the burden should not be on the shoulder of the Muslims. Okay, next, Sir Syed also tried to clear up the misunderstanding among the British who were angry being called as Nadarat by the Muslims. So how he cleared the misunderstanding by British thought it was insult for them, but Sir Syed pointed out that word came from Nasir means helper. So he cleared the misunderstanding by telling them that the word is Nasir and it means helper. Then next point is convincing the Muslims. He corrected the errors that were presented in a book written by British on life of our Prophet. He also wrote the Bainul Kalam, in which he pointed out similarities between Islam and Christianity to lessen the gap between British and Muslims. British Indian Association was built to increase cooperation between the two peoples, encouraging the growth of Western education. So he also worked for this thing as well, that he encouraged the growth of Western education. Discrimination by British towards Muslim community and support towards Hindus led Sir Syed Ahmed Khan to take steps to change Muslim attitude towards receiving British education. In doing this, he came into conflict with ulama. They believe that acceptance of Western scientific and technological ideas will weaken their Islamic belief. Sir Syed believed that Holy Quran emphasized the need to study the scientific beliefs in order to reveal full majesty of God. To gain support for his views, Sir Syed set up an Urdu journal called Tehzeebul Akhlaq. It contained ideas of influential Muslims and their support to Sir Syed Ahmed Khan's beliefs. In 1863, Sir Syed founded the Scientific Society at Ghazipur. Its main purpose was to make scientific knowledge available to a wider market by translating them into Urdu from English, Persian, and Arabic. He showed his commitment towards expanding education opportunities and opened a school in Muradabad in 1859. In 1869, Sir Syed travelled to England to study the university system. He wanted to have Oxford or Cambridge level university for Muslims of subcontinent, but he was looked with suspicious eyes after returning home. So he laid the foundation of a school rather than a university. A committee was set up which toured the country raising funds for a new Muslim school. On 24th May 1875, The Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College was set up in Aligarh on the pattern of English public school system. The college offered both Western and Indian education, though Islamic education was also provided. Many of the future leaders got education from there and it became symbol of Muslim unity. However, Sir Syed's work in education did not end here. He wanted to publicize the new education methods being used at Aligarh. So in 1886, he set up the Mohammedan Education Conference. Its aim was to raise educational standards among Muslims. The conference attracted famous orators and writers and also played a major role in establishing a political platform for Muslims. In 1920, the college became the University of Aligarh. Okay, next, increasing political awareness. That was also related to the work of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, that Sir Syed was determined to improve status of Muslims by writing essays on the causes of Indian revolt and the loyal Mohammedans of India. He had shown a desire to re-establish good relationships with the British. Sir Syed realized that the British were too powerful to be overthrown and that Muslims would gain more by cooperating with them. He also believed that Muslims should have good relations with Hindus as they have a common long-term aim to restore the authority of the local people in their own country. In a speech to the Indian Association, he said, "We Hindus and Muslims live together on the same soil under the same government. Our interests and problems are common, and therefore I consider the two factions as one nation." Later on, he realized that the two groups cannot work together, and Hindus and Muslims have separate identities, and they are two separate groups within the subcontinent. Indian National Congress. In 1885, Indian National Congress was formed. The British saw this body as a means by which they could hear the views of the educated elite in Indian society. The Congress claimed that it would represent the views of all the communities, regardless of their religion. Later on, it became apparent that the Congress was a Hindu-dominant body which was working to establish Hindu culture. Political representation. Hindus were more in politics than Muslims. Sir Syed spoke angrily on this matter, saying, "I am convinced that the introduction of the principle of election would be attended with evils of greater significance. The larger community would totally override the interest of the smaller community." Competitive examination. Congress also suggested that appointment in the government service should be by competitive examination. Since Muslims were not getting education of a standard similar to Hindus, so it would greatly disadvantage them. So Sir Syed commented that when equal opportunities were given to both Hindus and Muslims, could such an idea work? Language. Another concern of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan's were Hindu-Urdu controversy. In 1867, Hindus demanded that Hindi should be made next official language instead of Urdu, which had become the official language in 1825. This became another guiding factor for Sir Syed's towards his two-nation theory. In some areas, Hindus were showing disrespect and playing loud music outside mosques. So it became difficult for Hindus and Muslims to live in peaceful coexistence. Importance. Now we will tell about that what was the importance of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan and his work. He worked tirelessly to restore relations with the British, particularly after War of Independence. He played a vital role in bringing about a Muslim revival, largely through the work of Aligarh movement. Linked to the Muslim revival was a greater political awareness and developed his two-nation theory. So this was all about this chapter, chapter number 4. I hope all the things are clear to you. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.